Hi, welcome along to this edition of the vlog. I'm David Bailey, an Englishman in the Balkans, and I live in a village in northwest Bosnia and Herzegovina. It's a very autumnal day today. I think you can see over my shoulder. It's very grey, a bit chilly, too chilly actually, to be sat in a t-shirt. In past years, I've always made a video about making rakija, making Šljivovica, making plum brandy, and of course some apple brandy as well. But this year, I thought I'd do something slightly different and spend half a day with my neighbours during their Šljivovica making process. Here in the Western Balkans, literally translated, it's called baking rakija, in other words, baking the brandy. What actually happens is weeks and weeks and weeks before the end of the fruit season, windfalls are picked up, whether they're apples or the plums, and they are put into large vats. You can buy these vats from local hardware stores, different sizes, but normally they're as big as you can possibly get. And then over those weeks, all the windfalls, as I say, are collected and put into these vats. And then at the end, using large sticks, the remaining fruit is knocked off the trees, then collected up and put in the vats, where they stay for another good few weeks as they ferment down. I think the English term is that turns into a mash. When the mash is ready, it is then time to start the process of baking the rakija, in other words, distilling the brandy. Now, this can happen in two ways. Either people with quite a lot of money can buy a still, and yes, you can buy them from the local hardware stores. Not quite sure how much they cost. They're not cheap, but some families do have their own. Or you wait till one is free and you hire it and you bring it in for the period that you're going to be doing the distilling. This year with my neighbour, it's the property here where I live and my neighbour's property, both families get together to make their rakija, and this year it took 2 days. The rakija still is set up. It consists of what I could best describe as the boiler. So there is a fire underneath and a container on top with a mash, and water gets put into. Then there's a pipe that feeds the condensation from the boiling fruit through a water-filled container, and of course as the condensation returns into liquid form, out the other end comes the brandy. So the whole process basically from there is get that fire going early in the morning, then start to bring the mash out in small buckets, and then start filling it into the boiler part. There is a grinding mechanism there to make sure that the fruit is being agitated inside the boiler as it is boiling. And then the experienced men from the village will tell you exactly when the condensation is then moving through the pipe to come through the other end down through, in this case, as you can see on the video, the big blue drum, and then out of that comes the brandy. The brandy is then measured to see how much alcohol it's got. I think this year for us it was around about 53 to 55%. When that liquid is in that bucket, however, I don't know if you can see on the video, if you look very closely, there's a little bit of scum, and that is taken away, that scum, by pouring into large demijohns the finished rakija, but it goes through a muslin cloth. After going through the muslin cloth, these demijohns are then stored. Some people will drink young rakija. I find it a little bit too strong for me, too much of a kick, but normally then it's kept for a number of years and then used for drinking at home, on celebrations, or for giving as gifts, which is quite common here. And if you've got exceptional rakija, I think you can sell it by the bottle to local restaurants. This year's crop for us here was 280 litres. You might think that's a lot, but when it's split between two families, that comes down to about 140 litres each. As I say, rakija is used for religious festival days, feast days, and that's a big thing here, especially in this part of the country. As I say, it's also given away as gifts, and people will normally take one or two shots of rakija during the day for, as they say, medicinal purposes. So although it sounds a lot, It's not really. This rakia, as I said, will be kept for a number of years before it's consumed. The longer it stays, the better. It is clear, but some people also put wood in it so that it takes the brown colour, so it becomes more brown, like a French brandy, for example. And other people, instead of keeping it in glass demijohns, like to put them into oak or other wooden barrels, so once again the colour is taken from those barrels. It's a very traditional activity in the countryside especially. Legend does have it that during the communist era of Tito that the stilling of alcohol in villages was banned, and so the skills kept on as a sort of underground or pirate activity. But I have to say, since I've been living here for the last 14 years or so, it's been something that I've seen every year. As you drive through the streets, through villages, you'll see people in their front gardens or in their back fields with these little mobile stills, puffing away, the smoke going out, and making their own alcohol. So that's it. Making rakia in Bosnia and Herzegovina in 2016. I hope you like the video. If you do, if you'd like to subscribe to the channel, that would be great. Give it a thumbs up would be even better. And if you've got any comments, I will certainly try and answer them. So just to show you, this is what it's like. This is rakia from a few years ago. And I'll just take a quick sip of this. I'm not going to drink the whole glass in front of you. This I've never seen consumed as a shot drink, in other words throwing it down your throat, but more of a sipper. And that is really good Šljiva from about 2 to 3 years ago.